Ariana Grande disappointed millions of followers when she had to cancel a concert in Kentucky last week due to her not feeling well. Ariana Grande has reportedly been vegan since 2013, being a fairly prominent activist for animal rights. But who honestly believes she's vegan? I mean, it's definitely made a lot easier when you have a private chef, a personal trainer, and access to the highest quality organic produce there is. I mean, that being said, I wouldn't mind being Ariana Grande's personal chef, although she could do with a few hot Italian beef injections, that's for sure. All this considered, she is suffering because of the lack of animal foods in her diet.
So I woke up kind of 10 times worse, and it hurts so bad to swallow. I'm not really sure what's going on.
Ariana Grande devastated as she revealed that she would be canceling her show in Lexington, Kentucky on Sunday night due to being sick. She added in her Instagram stories that she was, quote, so sad and sorry to her fans, and promising that fans with tickets to that show would be refunded. Ari also shared a video of herself using a steamer to help her breathe regularly. And this came about a day after she let fans know she'd been feeling sick for over 3 weeks. And she explained that her throat and her head were still in so much pain. Ariana continued to express her disappointment in this tweet. She wrote, it sucks feeling like absolute bleep, but it sucks way more to not be with you all. You mean the world. I hope you truly know I love you. On that Instagram story, Ariana also said that she would cherish all the memories from her Sweetener World Tour, and that she's mad that she can't seem to get better to enjoy the last moments that she has with her fans before wrapping up the second leg of that tour. Ariana says that she will be visiting a doctor to try and learn more about her current condition. Her next show is scheduled for Tuesday in Atlanta, Georgia, and we hope that she gets better.
So she had to cancel a concert, her next hypothetical performance being at the Grammys in a few months. Even so, she tweeted that they should have an ambulance and some champagne nearby. And whether that was a joke or her actually being concerned for the future, it's clear that this is something she hasn't had happen to her before. Being sick for over 3 weeks, you know, her throat and head in so much pain, is certainly not normal for the average person, especially a hypothetically healthy young lady, to be so debilitated from a cold or flu. That is, unless they are on a very poor diet, lacking animal food. She is taking medications, on IV drips, and I don't think the severity of this has been illustrated too well in the media. She is seriously ill. You have to understand the amount of money on the line here. They would have pumped her full of any drug possible to get her on stage in front of these people. My mother and father got sick this season, but not my sister or myself. My sister follows a carnivore diet, as I do, rich in animal nutrition, fat-soluble vitamins, giving us all the nutrients we need for a strong immune system. My mother eats a reasonable amount of animal foods and was only sick for about a week. My father, who eats like 90% bread, Entenmann's scrub cakes, cinnamon buns, was sick as a dog, coughing up his lungs for about 2 months. He literally moved from my parents' bedroom to sleep in the basement for 2 months because of how sick he was. The problem here is specifically the lack of nutritious animal foods in the diet. Doesn't matter if you're vegan, keto, standard American diet, grain-fed carnivore, nature doesn't care. And the only foods that exist in nature to make you healthy are those quality animal foods. Grass-fed beef, pasture-raised pork, free-range chicken and eggs, raw dairy, wild-caught fish. Now, why exactly did she go vegan in the first place?
I love animals more than I love most people, not kidding, but I'm a firm believer in eating a full plant-based diet, whole food diet that can expand your lifeline and make you an all-around happier person.
At least she acknowledged in her statement that vegans are cute, cuddly animal lovers with no regard for other humans. Too bad everyone else recognizes the health, environmental, and ethical ideas around a vegan diet as truth and facts without questioning it. Our modern society and culture has molded us to be an echo chamber of ideas, dogma. Of course, broccoli is good for you. Of course, vegan farts, I mean cow farts, are ruining the climate. We know there is a lot of influence on celebrities from plant-based agendas. I think just about every single celebrity has been vegan at some point in the past few years. many cases and instances of their health deteriorating, whether the celebrity admitted to it or not. So thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, and share the video if you can. If you guys would like to support me further, please, please, as I just said, share the video. You can check out Frankie's Free Range Meat, high quality, nutrient-dense animal foods at an affordable price. You can also go to Frankie's Naturals for minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. If you guys want guidance to improving your health, send me an email, frankatofano@gmail.com. Thanks again for joining me, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. You guys are insulting me a lot in the comments lately, saying I'm out of shape, saying I'm not gaining muscle. We'll see. We'll see 2 months from now.